Hello friends, welcome to my another video session of Java tutorial. In this session I am going to cover two topics. First one, I am going to tell you about each and every element of a simple Java class, and second thing I am going to tell you about that the name of a class and the name of the source file it is necessary to keep both of them same or different. Okay, let's see. First thing, here you can see a simple Java class, like public class first. That is a simple Java class, and in between that there is a public static void main. We will going to talk about main method in next slide. First, I'm going to tell you about public and static and first. Here first is a user defined class name. It can be anything like your name, my name, or study viral. I can use anything as a class name which is user defined, and this class is a keyword which is known by Java compiler that it is a keyword. And if we write anything after this class keyword, like first, that is a user defined class name. And public, in every Java file, Java source file, there should be only a single public class. If you are writing two or three classes within a single source file, then only one file should be public. You cannot make every class public. You can make number of classes within a source file, but only single class should be public in that particular source file. Here public is a SS specifier, and in Java there are four types of SS specifiers. First one is a private, which is only accessible within its package. And second thing is protected, third public, and fourth is default. And this class, these brackets are the block of this class. It means that anything declared inside these block is a part of this first class. Okay, that thing is a very simple. This is a simple structure of a Java class. Now in next slide I am going to talk about public static void main. Okay, main method is a very important method in each and every programming language, starting from C and C++. As we know that in C or C++, the main method is the major thing from where our program is going to execute. And similarly in Java, the main method is also required by JVM to execute our Java program. So in this main method, the first thing is public access specifier. The public access specifier is required here with main method so that the JVM Java compiler, or we can say JVM, can easily approach this main method. So public, as public is accessible to each and every thing outside the class, and here public can access specifier help JVM to reach about main method. Second thing is static keyword. Here static keyword is required so that the main method does not need an object to access. As the property of a static keyword, as you can see here, static means this method works without object of the class. So if JVM need to access the main method, first thing, public specifier is required so that JVM can easily reach to main method. Second, we do not need an object of this class, like first class, and due to static keyword, the JVM can easily use main method without the need of an object of first class. And third thing is void. Here void is a return type of a main method. As similar to C and C++, void is a return type and it returns nothing. So main method returns nothing, so that is why there is a void return type. After that, there is a few parameter like string and some square bracket with args argument type variable. Here in Java, string with capital S is a class. It is a kind of a final class. I will discuss this class in later videos, but here string is a class which is required as a parameter in a main method. And here square bracket is a notification of an array. And where is array? args. args is an argument identifier variable of array type, which type string array type. And these two brackets are the block of main method. It means that anything written or declared within a main method body block, that is the part of main method. Okay, you can note down these kind of parameters which is rounded by this program. In next slide we can see the third line, system out print ln. Here system out print ln is a thing which take your any program part to console, like just pipelining your code to console for output. Here system is a class which is a final class declared in java.lang package, and out is an object defined in system class. But in next slide I am going to show where that thing exists, like system and other things. And print ln, here this is not I, this is l, small l. Okay, print ln is a method in which we put some string literals like hello Java or some variables so that our computer CPU take this kind of string literals or variable values to console output. Console output basically like command prompt where you can see some outputs of your Java program. Here dot operator, dot is a separate classes object and method so that class can reach to their method or object can access that method. So dot is a special operator with the help of which a class object can access their class methods, or some static or final class method can be accessible with the help of class. And next slide, there is little theory related to system. System is a class which exists in java.lang package. System class is always exist in this package. After that, out. Out is a static member of system class and is an instance of java.io.printstream. It is an instance of this thing. This is sometimes important in case of interview. And after that, println. println is a method which is also exist in java.io.printstream. And the important note, every Java program implicitly import java.lang package. If you do not import this package, but by default java.lang package is there in your every Java class. Okay, now I'm going to show you about some packages or some classes with the help of which you can know that which class or which package exist these kind of properties. For this, first of all, I'm going to stop this slide. Let me stop it first. Okay, now I'm going to open command prompt where you can see where these kind of classes are exist in your Java program. For that, we have to open a command prompt, and after that we have to type Java P, and after that name of the class. Like I want to show you about system class. For that we have to type Java P. After that java dot lang, which is a default package in each and every Java class. After that we have to type system. Okay, there is a lot of stuff. We need to find some properties here. Okay, this is a system, and you can see system is a public final class which exists in java.lang package. Here is out. You can see the out object here, which is a part of print stream. So whenever in case of interview, you can know about where the out instance came from. It is a part of print stream. What is a print stream? It is also a class, which is a final static class. Okay, after that, there is, you can also know about print stream by similar type this thing with the help of Java P. For example, here in bottom you can see Java P, after that Java dot io dot P capital print stream. There is a lot of stuff. Here in print stream, there is a print function or println function, which we were using in our previous slide. And also, there are many more things which later I am going to describe in my videos. Okay, the second point of this video is, for that I am opening a notepad in which I am making a class. Okay, make a class first, brackets. In this bracket I am going to type now public static void and main, again brackets, after that string args argument. You can make square bracket after that args, and up here I am going to type system dot out dot print ln. Hello study while. Okay, in my previous video, as you were seeing, that I'm always save this file with the name of that class file, but in this case I'm not going to do that. And I just save this file with some other name, like second dot java. After that, select this thing with all files, otherwise you will save this file as a .txt extension. Okay, now click on save button. After that, open the command prompt. Let me clear this screen first. Now I'm going to my working directory where my each and every Java file is stored. For that, cd desktop. After that, cd studyvirl. And now here you can see there are few files exist. This is my source file second. So I'm going to type java c, compile this file second, and let me show you the folder also at back. Okay, this is my Java folder. Let me arrange the screen first. Okay, now we can see each and everything here which is going in my working directory. Okay, now I'm going to enter here, and you can see this side what is going to happen. Now I'm entering this thing. Okay, here you can see that I compile this file. Now you are going to see that the first dot class extension thing came in existence. So that if you make a class name first or anything, and if that class in a source file with different name, at the time of compilation you need source file name, and at the time of execution you need class name, like first without dot class extension and enter. Now you see this output, hello study viral. So in this video, you know about something about each and every component of a simple Java class, and also you are able to know about the source file name and class file name should be same or shouldn't be same. So thank you for watching this video and do subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.